Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will show you an easy way to draw correlation coefficient plot using this SRplot website. By using this website, you can easily draw your correlation coefficient plot for your data in the form of this full or half triangle like this. Wherever you want, whether you want upper triangle, lower triangle, or you want it in the form of square. And you can also calculate the p-values at the same time with just using a single click. So before I show you how we can prepare the file, let me show you how you can access to this website. SRplot website is totally free for researchers, and let me show you how you can go to this website. The website is actually bioinformatics.com.cn/en for English version. So when you will click on this, it will ask you to log in. The login is totally free and it will give you 50 points for free. After you have login, and if you don't want to create your login, you can simply use this test account new Core Biotic in the login, and you can use this as a password. But I will recommend you can use your own account, as this is totally free. So after that, you can simply write here correlation. So you can see there are three types of correlation plot. One is Pearson-Spearman scatter plot, one is correlation dot, and one is correlation coefficient plot. And here in this box, you can input your data and you can prepare your correlation coefficient plot in the form of these figures. So let me show you how you need to arrange your data, and you can directly paste that data into this box. So here is one example. You can see here we have the different name of motor cars which are being used in United States. And here you can see we have different Mazda, RX, and here are the different actually motor car types. And here you can see this is the main variable which is dependent on the different variable. Actually, this is the mileage per gallon. So here you can see we have the data of mileage per gallon. And here are the different other variables of engine, like number of cylinders, displacement, horsepower, and ratio, weight, Qsec, and similarly velocity, and whether this is automatic or manual, and number of gates and number of carburetors. So we want to know which variable is most positively and significantly correlated with this our MPG, that is mileage per gallon. So you can also arrange your data in the form of this. Here are the different, like if you are taking any plant example, so here can be the main yield, here can be the yield in the form of kg per acre or kg per hectare, and here could be number of branches, number of tillers, etc., and number of cranes. So whatever is your data, so you can arrange it, the first variable and then the various variables which contribute to this final variable. So after you have arranged your data, so you can simply copy this data. Let me show you. You can simply copy this data and you can directly paste this data into that box. So I have just pasted that data. So after you have pasted your data in this table, so you can choose figure size and correlation number size. Here, like figure size, you can leave it to the default figure size, width and height, and similarly you can choose the correlation number font size and correlation digital number. I will recommend you can use 2. And from here you can choose correlation method, Pearson or Spearman. I will not go into the detail. Whatever you want to use, you can use as per your need. And here are the correlation color, and as we know, the correlation values between -1 to +1. So the lowest color would be this. You can change if you want. And the highest color is this. You can also change if you want. And here are the different methods to build this. Let me show you through this example. Here are the method whether you want this data in the form of circles, squares, ellipse, number, shades, color, pie, whatever you want to choose. In this example, we can choose this color, and here are the shape. So whether you want as a full, like if you want full, so it would be like this. And if you want lower triangle, so you can choose lower triangle and upper triangle. Similarly, like this one, you can see this is lower triangle, and here is this one is upper triangle. So the next one is display p values. Yeah, we must should have p values to check the significance. So you should must select here the yes so that it can show the p values, and here you can also select the p significance level. So we know that anything less than 0.05 would be significant, so we can select the first one. And here what you want to show them the insignificant values, like here in this example you can see the insignificant values do not have stars. So like here you can see you can select this one. Label significant and insignificant would be without this, and significant would be with this star value. So here you can see the non-significant do not have this, and significant all have the stars. So similarly, if you don't want that insignificant p labeled would be with the cross axis. In this example you can see the insignificant values are automatically crossed. So you can choose whatever you need. So in this example we can choose this one, and from here you can select font family, and after that you can submit. But must remember that you should must log in before submitting this data. So I will submit this. You can see our graph is generated. So now we can download it in the form of PDF, PNG, SVG. So let me download it in the form of PDF. So here you can see our graph is ready, and we can directly use it in the form of this figure. So in this figure you can see the mileage per gallon has positive correlation with these blue dots, like this ratio, like VS, AM, number of gear, and those one which are mentioned in this color, they are actually the negatively associated, I mean negatively correlated with this. And here are the dots, it means they are actually the non-significant. So in this way you can also draw your correlation coefficient plot using this website. So hopefully this website will be useful in drawing your correlation coefficient plot. If you have still any question in the use of this SRplot website or this correlation coefficient plot, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.